Well, hello everybody, and welcome back to another reaction video. And today I don't really know what to say. You guys have randomly, of recently, started recommending Chris Webby's Raw Thoughts 5 for some reason. 5, just specifically 5. And I see that he has got more than one. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. But for some reason, you guys want me to check out 5. So, I've never heard of this guy. I don't know anything about him. But I checked out Samson, and you guys said, if you like Samson, you got to check out Chris Webby. And I was like, I loved Samson. I can't wait to check out more Samson stuff. So maybe I do need to check out Chris Webby. So that's why we're here. Know nothing about this guy. Never heard him before. Don't know his style, flow, what he looks like. Anything. Completely ignorant to the existence of this man. Up until seeing his name pop up in the comment section of Samson's 46 equals 13. So, I'm not going to waffle. We're going to jump straight into this one. And we're going to check out Chris Webby's Raw Thoughts 5. And if you guys like this video and if the video does well and you guys enjoy it and you want to see more, then maybe we'll check out some more of his stuff. We'll check out 1, 2, 3, and 4. Maybe. Anyway, I'm really curious. I don't really know what to make. No idea. So enough of my waffling bollocks. Before I jump into this video, make sure you hit that like button. And make sure you subscribe if you aren't a member of the family already. Hit that subscribe button and join the family. We are a kind, caring, cuddling kind of family. So subscribe and join the family. Anyway, let's jump into it.
There's a lot of opinions floating around these days. And I got my own. They may not be publicly acceptable, they may get me canceled, but it's my goddamn American right to speak them.
Damn straight.
If you got a problem with that, suck my dick. In a world made for the weak, the meek, the beta males and the sheep, too soft for debate. If they don't agree, then they just block and try to censor whatever you speak. Only like minds on the timeline that they see. They anti this and anti that. So close-minded, really, they just anti-facts. And you can show them the proof. But if it doesn't all align with their views that they've been programmed with from the news, then they don't want to hear it or even fucking be near it. See, the truth is too much for their spirit. That's why they fear it. They try to tell me no, but fuck it, I'ma say it anyway. I've been waiting for the government to kill me any day.
Damn. Damn. Damn! I'll make you jump. I can 100% see why you guys have been recommending this one after we checked out Samson. This is a, this is insane. This is insane. One thing I'm loving about you guys and your guys' recommendations is you seem to be feeding me some really gifted lyrical geniuses at the moment. And I have only heard 50 seconds of this song. And I can already tell Chris Webby is going to fall straight into that category.
Tell me no, but fuck it, I'ma say it anyway. I've been waiting for the government to kill me any day. What the fuck? I'm not important enough? Must I talk about the vax, how they poisoning us? Or the Vatican and all the little boys that they touch? I'm not scared. Shit, it's not like I'm avoiding this stuff. Yeah, the First Amendment still lives on through me and certain other motherfuckers who ain't on TV. We the last dinosaurs alive in AD. When we're gone, then you really know that freedom ain't free.
100% fucking fact. 100% fucking fact. We don't have freedom of speech over here in the UK, by the way. We adopt it, but it's not a law. It's crazy. And so we adopt it. We know it's right, but it's not a law. You know, you're not going to get like arrested. Like a protest over here can be quite shitty sometimes, especially when it, you know, when, I mean, you know, you only need to look at the London 2012, I believe, riots or whatever it was back in the day. Jeez. Anyway, but like he said, Free thinkers, people who are expressing their thoughts and opinions, people who are speaking the truth, are endangered species, and you do not see them on the TV. You do not see them on the TV. Hell, Tom McDonald's, what, had one interview on Fox News? And that guy is crazy huge. It's nuts. They're literally an endangered species. You get people like Samson, Chris Webby, Tom McDonald, Upchurch, all voicing their opinions, all saying what we need to do, and they are just pushed down to the bottom of the important pile. And their message is so bloody important, and it's so true. When you hear these people rap, like right now, it's just facts. It's not bollocks. It's not money, cars, fame, women. It's facts.
But if everybody got to showing some balls, these agendas they've been pushing would be slow to a crawl. But y'all so fucking soft, obeying and going along, sitting there triggered over a song. I know the type, got a Black Lives Matter sign on the front porch, never had a black person in the house. Yeah, it's time to call them out. Virtue signal motherfuckers ain't about shit, they just running at the mouth with these pre-programmed points of view and these ludicrous facts. Asian hate, stop acting like you knew about that. If you need a safe space, there's some room in the back with fresh vaginal wipes you could use while I rap. Pussy, yeah, it helps them all sleep at night knowing they signed a petition for equal rights for transgenders, talking like it's their fight when in reality they never met one in their life. They don't donate or actually do nothing about it. They just sit there, sit sipping Mountain Dew on their couches while they clapping for each other in circle jerking themselves. Applaud the loss of freedom and cancel those who rebel. And I'm the bad guy cause I'm white and not gay, which means that I'm a bigot and discredits what I say. But I'd rather have some toxic masculinity than have an inner bitch in me, bitch, so suck a dick of three. See the algorithms keeping you lost, and now you're caught in an echo chamber of your own thoughts. Let me talk while I can and speak to all my supporters before there's lawyers, threats, and gag orders.
This is insane. This is insane. This is the beat, the flow, the guy's voice, everything, the way he's sitting on that track. This is really good. This is really, really good. This is a fucking awesome recommendation. I'm loving this.
While I can and speak to all my supporters before there's lawyers, threats, and gag orders. Cause nowadays that's the American way with this false administration that has led us astray. They want the country to heal, but they don't spell with an A. What they mean is to obey and do whatever they say. But we tired of that. So when I'm here to rap, I got a duty to the people to bring light to the facts. Never see a day I'm taking it back. If I gave a shit, then I'd use a mask for wiping my ass. And when it comes to the shot, I don't care if you got it. Why you care if I didn't? I'm not understanding the logic. Shit, it's such a hot topic, you can get them in malls. I just got my 8th booster, fucking round of applause. People scared to say it, so they just say nothing instead. So let me make myself clear so they don't twist what I said. Hell yeah.
I avoid a lot of that stuff. You guys might have noticed that by now. I avoid a lot of that stuff. I try and stay down the middle as much as possible because every single one of you watching right now, I value every single one of your opinions. Every single one of you. This is a family and a community, and we don't all agree on everything here. That's just the truth. We don't all agree on every single thing here. We don't like the same music. We don't like the same food. We don't follow the same rules. You know, we don't all agree on the same thing, and that's okay. That's okay, because it's our differences that make us special and make us get to learn to like and, you know, respect one another. And it's important to do that. That's what Tom says. Don't let your differences cause hatred. People are different to you. Your neighbor's different to you. Doesn't mean you have to hate them. Doesn't mean you have to hate them. And so when it comes to the vaccination policy, the only thing I will say, on that right now is there's a YouTuber called Grade A Under A, and he did a video on coronavirus. If you would like to know my opinions on it, go watch that video. Grade A Under A, and he did a video on coronavirus. Because what he says in that is how I feel about it. I'm not going to say it now. So if any of you want to actually find out, go check that out after this video, all right? Let's jump back into this.
So they just say nothing instead. So let me make myself clear so they don't twist what I said. Hell yeah, I'll get the shot with a gun to my head after they pull the trigger and they vaccinate me dead.
And I ain't no Democrat, I ain't no fucking Republican either.
These motherfucking raw thoughts.
I'm a free-thinking citizen of the United States of America, God damn it.
What he's just said there. I love it. It's so true. It's good to have your brothers and sisters back. I'm really enjoying this one. I'm really enjoying Chris Webby's throw, the chorus, everything about this. This is a really good one. You guys are smashed it with the record.
I'm a free-thinking citizen of the United States of America, God damn it.
Raw thoughts.
And I've been seeing where this world's going, where this country's going. It makes me sick.
These motherfucking raw thoughts.
Fuck the new world order. Take that vaccine and shove it up your ass.
Raw thoughts.
Oh, y'all thought I was done? Hell no. This is raw thoughts. You know how we do. Line these motherfuckers up. It's time to get to work.
Where should I start? Joe Biden, I guess. Old Yeller. Shit, I'm honestly surprised he hasn't died on us yet. You ain't our president, dog. Shit, you don't have to pretend. Come on, Joe. We all know that you ain't actually win. Yeah, them puppet strings holding you up. Weak into Bernie's. Dementia really slowing you up. Should we be worried? You're tripping upstairs. Then you're sniffing on hair. Someone go and get this geriatric man a wheelchair. And then you got a son making lots of loot from the Ukraine. And blew it on prostitutes. So I'll snort a line of crack rock off the protective case up on Hunter Biden's laptop, so I'm typing in caps lock like
Jesus Christ. Does this guy know Samson? I can see why you guys recommended it. There is a lot of similarities in these two. Chris Webb is giving me old school flipping Eminem vibes. Obviously his flow is much slower. Eminem was known for being quicker, being a bit more aggressive, and Chris Webby is much more tame, obviously not in his lyrics, but I mean tame vocally, whereas in Eminem is quite an aggressive vocalist. Whereas in Chris Webby, he's quite a tame vocalist and a bit slower. But definitely giving me those sort of vibes as well. I'd like to hear what he sounds like on an aggressive track. Because I reckon he could easily sort of go down the Eminem sort of style.
Like, hi Fauci, I seen that mail leak, dog. Better get a better antivirus called a Geek Squad. Yeah. The king of backtracks. Last time I seen that many wrong numbers was me
when I fail math class. In Gen Saki, I'm getting sick of that lying twat fire crotch. Always trying to tell me they'll require shots. But if it's shots that they want, I'll let them have it. If they knocking on my door, checking my vaccine status. Andrew Cuomo, grabbing asses like the old days. Still had time to kill more
this
old people than old age. We all hate you, judge and defame you. I speak for all Italians, we don't claim you. Injected Rachel Maddow with a fatal strain of mad cow. Walked her up a massive flight of steps and kicked her back down. See your news come out, make me wanna smack the dick right out of Anderson Cooper's mouth. So ask your senator, pass me the AstraZeneca vax. Your relative's dad, go and jab your stepmother rapid. Testing your ass when you have a temperature shit. We gone nuts, don't vax the messenger.
I have not heard. I'm gonna say this right now. I don't know how well this video is gonna do. I said at the beginning, if it does well, I'll check out his other stuff. So I don't know. When we check out new artists, sometimes they do better than others. But I'm going to say it right now to anyone watching this right now. Anyone in this part of the video right now. No one has rapped like this since Eminem. No one. No one has rapped like this since Eminem. And I don't mean the style. I don't mean the flow. I mean the people are too scared these days to rap like Eminem used to. And I don't know if you guys know what I'm going to say when it comes to violence. There's a song by Eminem called Criminal. And he literally has like a minute long verse in that song where he's just talking about shooting people. He's like, he robs a bank, and then he's like, I'll come back, I'll shoot that, I'll shoot this, I'll shoot a puppy, I'll shoot everybody, and he's just like doing that, and the whole idea is, and then Eminem came out and said, because the opening of that song is what I talk about on record, you know, people think I'm actually going to do in real life, and he's like, well, if they think that, then I'll kill them too, and it's obviously a fucking joke, right? But people are so offended by it that they just take it as seriously, and that was Eminem's whole flipping, you know, whole flipping persona. And no, Chris Webby is the first rapper I have heard since old Eminem to talk about it like that. This is nuts. This guy is giving me strong Eminem vibes. Am I the only one who got that? Like, I'm just saying, I want to hear him on an aggressive track because I reckon he could really pull it off. I have not heard an artist like this in a long time. Samson is amazing. One of the best lyricists coming up, hands down. But his style is very different to Chris Webby. And what I'm saying is Chris Webby's style seems to follow that vibe. Old Slim Shady days. I'm really enjoying this. Obviously, as a British person, I don't have many opinions when it comes to American politics. I try and keep my nose out of it because it ain't my fucking business. It ain't my business. And I hate it when people all over the world tell you how other countries should be thinking. You know, we get some Australian news reporter and it's the same with any Australian. I know I've got a few Australian waffle gang watching this right now, but it's the same with like if you watched us over here in the UK and we were talking about issues in Australia, we don't have a fucking opinion. We just keep our fucking opinions to ourselves. We're not part of it. We don't know. I don't know what's going on in America. I don't live there. I see, and everything I get is fed down through the news as watered down bollocks anyway. So I rely on you guys. I rely on you guys in the comment section down below to tell me what's going on. And I take your word for it, not the fucking news for it.
Send your ass when you have a temperature shit. We gone nuts, don't vax the messenger. Like Kamala Harris and Guantanamo Barrack. She's incarcerated so many people, I think it merits. Leaving her there to rot, she deserving of it either way. Just be sure you don't forget to go and throw the key away. Now you can call me insane, but Ted Cruz is actually growing on me. Wait, let me explain. Shotwise, he's been freedom of choice. While also fighting for the First Amendment, which I need for my voice to get out. So no matter how bad that I want to hate, I give credit where it's due. I know it's a hot take, but before I'm off the subject, wait, you still ugly. Shit, Arya Stark won't even wear your face. I'll impregnate Melinda Gates. She said my...
See what I mean? Fucking brilliant. My dick was great. Fucking brilliant.
I said, shut up, bitch. Get back in the kitchen. Fill my dinner plate. Then I liquidated Bill's estate. Blew their
this
house
guy's
up
nuts.
With them in them, let them incinerate. Gathered up their ashes and slipped them into some boxes. The FDA approved it and shifted off to the masses. Had some side effects, but they ain't worried about that shit. Long as I ain't tell no one and pay my taxes. Get your vaccine, shoot up like 15. And don't forget to go collect your free Krispy Kreme. Go and get tested for fun to get a swab high. Cause there's nothing quite like huffing ethanol oxide. And Zuckerberg will try to censor my words. Jack Dorsey shadow banning this revenge of the nerds. New rules trying to regulate life as it was. More mandates than gay night at the club. So I'm sorry that I had to come and stop the show before we all need a motherfucking shot to go anywhere. So someone had to come and rock the boat and say shit that even Tom McDonald won't. And I'm just...
Oh, shit. The guy fucking referenced the one, the only, the legend Tom McDonald. And, it, you know, props, like he does, props are given where prop is due. And this guy is going over the fucking line, 100%. He is taking shots at fucking everybody. He is holding no one's butt. So I know he's mentioned Tom McDonald. That's not a dig. That's not a dig at Tom McDonald. Because Tom McDonald, like he just said, Tom McDonald, that guy is doing, is the master at getting the voice out there. Tom, if it wasn't for Tom McDonald, fuck me, the world would be so silent. That guy is pushing so much of an amazing message to the people. But Chris Webby has taken Tom McDonald's message. He's going, yo, Tom, I love what you're doing. How about I throw some, like, shooting people and stuff in there? And he's just made it this X-rated fucking insane stuff. And that's what I'm taking away from that. That's not a shot at Tom McDonald, man. That's, if anything, he's saying Tom McDonald is there with him. But he's taking Tom McDonald and he's going mega X-rated with it. Mega X-rated. I have not heard anyone this fucking violent and crazy. Not in a bad way at all. In a long time. This style is I thought was gone.
One guy with the balls to say what I see, even if I sound off the ways. All I
Wait. What was that? Was he talking about? Let's go back.
Had to come and rock the boat and say shit that even Tom McDonald won't. And I'm just one guy with the balls to say what I see, even if I sound off the ways. All I know is that we're way too lost to save. At this point, I could write a raw thoughts a day. Shit, but these are my opinions, and I'm allowed to speak them. You wanna get the shot? Do you? It's called freedom. You don't, then you don't. Stop forcing vaccinating. Cause to me, that's like pushing pork belly on a vegan. I mean it.
Exactly what Tom McDonald says. You know, if you want to get it. You know, if I don't, leave me alone. You know, it's like what Tom McDonald says. We're all here once. We are all here once. In this body, in this mind, right now, you are on this planet once. Live your life how you want to. Why do we have to be so controlled? Why? The people that are controlling us, are they controlled? Can we not just live our lives where we want? We're only here once. It's a short time on this planet. Short existence. Just let us be happy.
Agree with my views, that's all fine. I respect you for
and we'll
yours.
Let you do
respect
you.
Me for mine. We don't gotta draw a line in the sand.
Exactly what you just said. I'll respect you for your thoughts. Just respect me for mine. That's it. We're all brothers and sisters. I respect you for what you say. Respect me for what I say. And together we can be brothers and sisters.
All fine. I respect you for yours. Respect me for mine. We don't gotta draw a line in the sand or nothing. Just respect the motherfucker that'll stand for something. So keep watching the news and keep trusting the numbers. I'll keep digging for truth and tell them what I discover as they cancel motherfuckers just for raising their hand. I'll pull my megaphone out and get to taking a stand. Raw thoughts.
Plot twist. It was him the whole time. Right. What are you guys doing to me? I'm some random British guy. You guys are giving me stuff like this. What the hell am I supposed to say? Chris Webby Raw 4. Damn. You guys blew my mind with Samson, and there was a lot I could agree about. And you guys have blown my mind again with Chris Webby. Jeez. This guy's nuts. This guy is insane. This guy is actually insane and is awesome. It's awesome. Obviously, like he said, and I'm not going to agree with everything he said, I agree with a lot of it. I don't want to go down that road. But what I'm saying is, like, the message that he is trying to push is such an important one. The message Tom McDonald is trying to push is such an important one. This is where I'm going to end this video on. The message they are trying to push is so important, and it's a suppressed message. Every single day it's suppressed. And that is, for fuck's sake, can't we just get on? Why does the government want us just to hate each other all the time? Why does the news want us to hate each other all the time? Why can't we just get on? Why? Why is this so hard? That's why I love this fucking community. Every time I read the comments, it's just awesome, amazing people. I love each and every one of you. You really are the best of the world. Every time I read these comments, I'm blown away. Before I went down this rabbit hole of Tom McDonald and discovered all these other artists, I didn't realize, like, were you guys like me? Were you out there thinking that everyone else was like a robot or something? You were like, how are these people so blind to what's going on? And then we've got this community and it's like, fuck me, there are actually people out there who think the same? Man, it's so refreshing. That was insane. I hope this video does well because I really want to come back and check out some more of this. This is really good. Make sure you blow this video up, like it, comment, do all the good stuff. I want to check out the other four. That was insane. Anyway, if you like this video, leave a like. Chris Webby, Jesus, that guy's blown my mind. Leave a like, make sure you subscribe and join the family. Thank you so much for watching. I love each and every one of you. And as always, you will see me in the next video.